Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good afternoon to all my beloved student. Okay, so again we meet yesterday during lecture, now is during tutorial. Right, so again teacher would like to remind you all always stay safe at home. Okay, kalau tak perlu keluar, tak payah keluar eh. Right, and hoping you all boleh balik college as soon as PKPB and hoping tak apa ni, tak lanjutkan lah eh. Alright, so today before we proceed, we would like to welcome our new members. Okay, Liu Shi Wen. Betul tak tu? Shi Wen. Okay, so Shi Wen, before we can proceed, teacher proceed discuss today's objective, teacher would like Shi Wen introduce a bit about yourself. Right, so nama panggilan, where you're from, okay, asal dari mana, okay, before this previous school, form 6 or any, maybe you diploma or any foundation. Okay, and if you have learned biology, until what topic, right? And sibling, okay, how many sibling and you anak keberapa eh? Okay, Shi Wen boleh turn on your camera and your, and also unmute your microphone. Shi Wen, cikgu nak kenal Shi Wen? Oh, itu Shi Wen. Okay, so Shi Wen.
My name is Shi Wen and I'm from Penang and I study in Foundation UTAT this year. Then I got study bio until mitosis and meiosis.
Okay, good.
And I don't have any sibling. I'm only one in my family.
Oh, anak tunggal lah ni. Penang, which area si Shi Wen?
Sungai Ara.
Sungai Ara is somewhere island ke?
Island, Penang Island. Island.
Oh, okay lah. Teacher dulu USM si Shi Wen. Okay, that's why when you mention Penang tu dekat di hati cikgu jugalah eh, because 5 years cikgu kat sana eh, Penang. Okay, Shi Wen, welcome to now you are at Penang.
Ah, at Penang.
Oh, okay. Nanti PKPB after done, then you welcome to Kuala Pilah lah, eh? Right? And don't worry, ramai kan kawan from Penang, right? Nanti you akan kenal. Okay, so congratulations. Shi Wen, okay, and welcome to our class. Alright, so actually, Shi Wen, this is already 10 week, okay? This week is only 10 week, and we have covered until chapter 6, okay? And letters chapter 6, they have to do their assignment. Okay, so this week, teacher lebih discuss about assignment, eh? Say, for these 2 hours, okay, teacher akan settle all the assignment. Okay, and by next week, you all the final touch up, okay, your assignment, okay, and ready to sell hand in atau turn in through GC. Okay, nanti later teacher akan add Shi Wen. Shi Wen dah dapat email belum?
Dapat.
Email, okay, nanti Shi Wen share dengan teacher eh, your email, okay, ataupun nanti teacher bagi class code. Alright, so for Shi Wen, don't worry, petang ni more to those ni senior student eh. So untuk UPS 1 and UPS 2, Shi Wen memang kena sit for the 2 UPS, but later, okay, because you have your own batch, nanti kita akan set up satu tarikh eh untuk your batch, okay. And for your tugasan, for memang you kena buat because memang wajib eh. But for the time being, you just follow dulu. Nanti teacher will let you know about your status eh, regarding assignment. Okay, Shiwon. So that a bit from me. Slowly, teacher hope all the apa ni members of S1CP3 do help Shiwon to catch up together, right? Before your final exam sebab kita ada lagi tolak minggu ni, kita ada lagi another 8 weeks. Okay, to settle your sem 1 before your final exam. Alright, so sedikit lah ice breaking with Shiwon. Okay, and hoping Shiwon happy. Okay, join our class. Okay, so today kalau you all tengok from what teacher mentioned Okay, so before that teacher would like you to sign up your attendance dulu, kan takut terlupa. Right, so you sign up your attendance dulu. Okay, for this week, for these 3 weeks, attendance teacher ubah sikit because it seems that every day kita ada apa ni, ada online classes. Okay, so to mudahkan cikgu handle your document, your attendance document, so teacher design ataupun your Google form teacher create like this. Right, so you need to, you can scan your QR code, okay, and you can fill up, fill in your name, right, then your metric number, okay, and then you can choose your practicum, and also select today's class session, Tuesday tutorial 20th. Okay, today cantik kan? Tarik 20.10.20. Okay, 3 to 4 PM. Alright, class so, kalau dah, then you submit and consider done. Okay. Is it okay, class?
Mana link, cikgu? Mana itu link?
Tak ada link QR code. Cikgu dah share code aku, tak boleh scan.
Tak ada. Tak ada pun itu QR code.
Di aku tak ada, teacher.
No, no, no. Tak ada QR.
Tak ada?
Yes.
Tak keluar pun slide ke apa.
Beja-beja ke kuah facecam cikgu je.
Oh, cikgu tak sharing. Sorry.
Apa?
Sorry, sorry.
Okay, teacher.
Excited sangat sampai tak sharing. Okay, sorry. Lupa nak sharing. Cikgu sharing sekejap Sekejap ya. Okay. Wait cikgu alihkan ni sekejap. Alright, nampak tak? Okay, so this is a QR code. You scan the QR code and you fill up all the particulars You have to fill up your name, your metric number, then you have to choose your practicum and your class session. And then you submit So this time, teacher kena setting the Google form like this. Because every day kita ada online classes So senang untuk kamu pilih je your class session for this week and then easier for me to manage your attendance. Okay, Shiwon slowly lah follow. Okay. Have you done class?
Yes, sudah, sudah.
Alright, okay, good. Okay, kalau sudah, now petang ni teacher select a few students. Okay, so far class ni teacher update sikit for your cikgu update sikit lah untuk tugasan. Okay, all of you dah submit. Okay, Cuma teacher nak update sekejap. Okay, Syauki Ikram cikgu baru terima mesej tapi dah submit ke? Farahana, Khairina dengan Nat, Kai, Farah, Ikram. Farah, ada apa ni? Ada apa nak cakap cikgu?
Saya tak submit lagi.
Okay, by this week eh.
Okay.
Nat? Nadira?
Saya pun tak submit lagi.
Okay, Khairina? Khairina? Kai, are you there?
Yeah, teacher. Nanti
okay, saya. Okay, so and last kali Ikram.
Saya pun belum submit.
Okay, so hope teacher hope sangat lah you all by this week. Okay, you can settle all your assignment ni. Because tak ada there is no penangguhan eh. Okay, tak ada penangguhan schedule. 2 November, you have to submit 2 November through you GC dulu, soft copy. Okay, and then afterwards, bila kita dah jumpa face to face after 6 November, right? 6 November tu hari apa eh? Jadi, the following ni tadi baru kamu akan submit hard copy. Okay, so nanti by end of this week, cikgu akan setting Google Classroom untuk you all turn in eh. Okay, by question nanti. Alright, so dah 3:25, okay. So, basically before holiday, teacher ada go through question Farid punya. Okay, example by Farid. Okay, so today teacher nak bagi satu lagi apa ni, sharing. Okay, this is from Farhana. Okay, so Farhana nanti you all dah boleh buat editing lah kalau ada teguran pada cikgu eh. Okay, so nanti question 3 from Dinesh Kumar and question 4 from Vihang. Okay, so jom kita start dulu tengok Farhana, infographic poster by Farhana. Okay, so after this, those yang dah yang ongoing boleh buat editing and then after that, finalize your poster eh, your infographic poster. Okay, so let's start. This is question 2. Okay, Farhana start with, tengok kat sini eh. Farhana start with step 1 without any introduction eh Farhana. Cuba cari step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5 and step 6. So Farhana, like teacher, I did mention before. Okay, for DNA replication, you kena jawab dulu eh. Explain the process that lead to the number of DNA becoming double. Okay, that one you kena beritahu dulu the process that lead the number become the DNA become double is DNA replication. Okay, Farhana, DNA replication. Okay, which consists atau replicated DNA consists of one old strand or and one new strand. Or apply semi-conservative model. Okay, Farhana, that point you tak ada eh. So, add in. Tak, kamu tak apa, hilang satu markah kat situ. Okay, next, what are the process? Okay, the process DNA replication and these are the step eh, in DNA replication. Okay, Farhana, start step 1, unwinding the double helix strand of DNA. Okay, kalau boleh DNA helicase ni turun bawah eh, Farhana, your setting. Okay, so for step 1, teacher akan cari 3 enzyme. Okay, again eh, just untuk ingatkan eh, enzyme helicase, okay, 1. And then, single stranded binding protein, 2. And topo isomerase, 3 eh, in order you to get 3 marks. So, nyatakan. Okay, state what's the function of DNA helicase involved in unwinding. Okay, Farhana, this one, okay. Single stranded, stabilize the unwound strand and topo isomerase, enzyme that relieve the tension, okay. So your diagram kat sini, where's your diagram? Diagram sini cari, ok Okay, teacher tak berapa apa ni, your diagram kalau teacher no marks eh. Okay, like this no marks eh, Farhana, so try to find a new one. Okay, a new diagram eh. Okay, diagram kalau boleh show eh class eh, the concept of the apa ni, the function of all the enzyme that mentioned. Okay, ada DNA helicase, okay, there is a SSBP and topoisomerase. Like that, try to find this diagram in order to explain the three function of enzyme. Okay, then step two synthesis of RNA primer. Okay, this one okay. Apa enzyme involved? DNA primase. Yes, betul. Synthesis RNA primer to initiate the process of replication by adding RNA nucleotide using apa ni? Tertinggal ni, using 3 prime end of parental DNA Farhana, tertinggal. Okay, as a template, the new DNA strand will start synthesis from the 3 prime, okay, end of the RNA primer. Okay, so gambar pun try to find another one eh Farhana. Okay, because this one tak nampak kan, teacher suka you nampakkan DNA like this, the double strand DNA. Okay, and then di sini ada primer, okay, DNA primase. Okay, RNA primer, DNA primase, RNA primer, DNA primase. So this one teacher tak berapa minat nak gambar ni Farhana. Try to find another one. Okay. Okay, next step 3 tak perlu gambar. Okay, step 3. Right, so step 3 is okay, assembling complementary strand. Right, so the enzyme table ialah enzyme DNA polymerase 3, betul. Okay, add the free nucleotide to 3 prime end of RNA primer and complementary to bases to bases of template. To bases of the template eh? DNA nucleotide to the 3 prime end of RNA primer and complementary to the bases of the template. Okay, so this strand grows in direction 5 to 3 since new nucleotide are added. New DNA nucleotide are added, okay, to the 3 prime end of the growing strand. Okay, so step 3 alright lah. Tak banyak sangat editing. Okay, actually ni just apa ni, reinforcement from your previous eh. Okay, so step 4, formation of leading and lagging strand. Leading and lagging strand, RNA primer. Okay, labelkan RNA primer eh, Farhana. Kozaki fragment, lagging strand pun label. Okay, RNA primer. Alright, fork progression. Nah, ini boleh lah. Okay, so two strand will be produced, leading and lagging strand. Leading strand is replication. Leading strand is replication. Macam mana tu? Leading strand is replication, Farhana. Leading strand is the strand that replicate towards the replication fork. Ini eh, kena betulkan ni. Okay, and involve only one primer. Yang ni, ini kena betulkan eh, Farhana. Farhana?
Okay, teacher.
Alright, okay. Lagging strand is, jauh Terengganu tu. Lagging strand is replication, ni eh, satu sekat sama juga ni eh, Farhana. Okay, away from the replication fork, more than one primer. Ya, ni okay lah. More than one primer needed, replication occur discontinuously for me Okazaki fragment. Okay, step 4, right? Okay, next, second last step, step 5, tak payah gambar. Okay, removing the RNA primer, eh, Farhana? Removing the RNA primer, okay. So, enzyme involved adalah RNA polymerase 1, DNA polymerase 1, tolong detail, eh. Remove the RNA primer and fill in the gap with DNA nucleotide as well as any gap. Okay, ni okay lah. So, yang tu eh, betulkan Farhana. Okay, next, the last step is step 6, joining the Okazaki fragment. Okay, next adalah enzyme involved DNA ligase, joining the Okazaki fragment by forming phosphodiester bond. Okay, two identical copies is produced. Okay, gambar kamu. Cari yang lebih better, Farhana. Okay, try to find a better one. Because step 6 ni dah final. Okay, try to find a better one because dah final. Eh, right? Ini macam baru nak start origin. Okay, origin ni tak payah sebenarnya. Ini tak payah sebab ini baru nak start. Eh, ni sekarang ni dah final product ni. Okay, so try find better one eh. Okay, boleh Farhana, do you have any question you want to ask? Okay, this also apply to all yang lain eh. You all boleh take note eh. Okay, done with question 2 sebagai ni. Okay, next we move to question 3. Dinesh eh. So, Dinesh buat dalam Word. So, teacher buka Word lah ni. Okay, so this is Dinesh one. Okay, so this is question 3. Okay, question 3 is a C3 eh. C3 level. That means you have to apply your understanding and your knowledge eh. Knowledge and understanding to answer this question. Alright, so hormone, antibody and enzyme are protein. These protein are synthesized from transcription of DNA replication. These protein are synthesized from transcription after DNA replication occur. Transcription is a synthesis of mRNA using DNA as a template. Okay, so ini introduction Dinesh. Okay, so where is your definition of transcription? Transcription is the process ni. Is a synthesis of mRNA using DNA as a template, tak tepat ni. Okay, Dinesh, your definition tolong betulkan eh. Ni kalau macam ni tak ada nomad eh. Tak ada markah ni, Dinesh. Definition ni sebut eh, the process by which genetic information okay, contained in DNA is transcribed into mRNA using RNA polymerase. Itu translation. Sorry, itu transcription. Okay, so untuk question 3 ni, guide kamu eh. Diagram 2 markah, okay, untuk transcription 5 markah eh. 5 markah untuk point, diagram 2 markah, am I right? Okay, kita tengok sekejap untuk apa refresh balik eh. Okay, untuk ingat balik kelas eh. So, like teacher mention, okay, transcription mesti ada definition, diagram 2 markah. 3 step transcription, 5 markah. Okay, so untuk transcription saja ada 8 markah eh. So kita tengok Dinesh able tak dapat 8 markah kat situ. Okay, so definition dia ni dah tak dapat, dah kosong Dinesh eh. Okay, untuk diagram transcription, this DNA. Kalau boleh cari tulis sini mRNA. Okay, mRNA. And kalau ada RNA polymerase lagi better. RNA polymerase lagi better eh Dinesh. Sebab definition of transcription itself. Okay, mesti sebut ada RNA polymerase. So kena ada RNA polymerase eh. Sebab kat sini dia akan bind promoter. Okay, so try to find another diagram eh Dinesh. To... Kalau macam ni nak bagi 2 pun tak dapat ni. Your diagram ni. Okay. Sebab dia nak tunjuk mRNA, RNA polymerase tak tunjuk. Because DNA polymerase yang paling penting eh. Untuk apa tu? Initiate the process of transcription. Am I right? Sorry, transcription eh. Okay. So, Dinesh, diagram tukar eh. Okay, next point. Okay, we move to point. Okay, step 1, initiation, yes, good. Promoter of gene nucleotide, the promoter of a gene nucleotide typically extends several dozen nucleotide pairs upstream from the, okay, ini tak payahlah kot ni. Right, kamu terus transcriptional, ini tak payahlah eh. Okay, terus transcriptional factors recognize the promoter region iaitu tata box and bind to the promoter to form transcription initiation complex. Okay, so ni dapat markah, ni dapat markah. Okay, 1-1 RNA polymerase then start transcription. Ini tak ada markah tapi ya, tak, ada pun tak, kalau biar kat situ pun tak apa. Okay, step 2 elongation, RNA polymerase add RNA nucleotide to the 3' end of growing RNA molecule as it continue along the double helix. Yes, 1 point. Then the new RNA molecule peels away from DNA template and DNA double helix reform. Right, another point. Okay, so elongation tak ada banyak, tak perfect eh. Okay, good eh Dinesh, tak ya, tak ada pembetulan. Okay, yang tadi initiation tadi ada. Okay, and then termination transcription proceed until the RNA polymerase transfer a terminator sequence. Ya, ini akan cuba cari. And the terminator sequence is a 100 of nucleotide yang kita panggil UA. Okay, UA lebih kurang 10 to 35 nucleotide. So this one, okay lah. Right, and produce the pre-RNA from, okay, right. Okay, done it. Termination pun tak ada masalah. So, tadi gambar dengan first step. Dinesh. Okay, then after that, the pre-RNA kena undergo RNA processing. Ada dua step. Right. So, first kena alter the pre-RNA. Okay, kena tambah cap. And kat ujung je ada tail. Okay. Apa ni? 5' cap. Okay, and poly A tail. Right. So, first kena alter. How to alter? Okay, tambah the prime end to the pre-RNA molecule as a cap end. Nitrogen besi, guanine. Okay, at the 3' end pula, enzyme added 5 to 220 adenine nucleotide to poly-ethyl. Poly-A, poly-ethyl. Okay. Right, so yang point yang ni tak sebut tak apalah Dinesh, tapi ada pun tak ada masalah. Okay, then after that RNA kena splice. Okay, RNA kena split and splice. Splicing to split the genes. Okay, so RNA splicing, remove intron. Okay, remove intron and kita nak exon, yes. Right, and so kat sini cikgu tak jumpa spliceosome. Saya tak ada tak word spliceosome. Okay, Dinesh masukkan siapa-siapa pun kalau tak ada dalam you punya ni tolong masukkan spliceosome spliceosome. Okay, tolong masukkan dalam you punya RNA RNA splicing kasi. Right. Okay, so next we proceed. Okay, your diagram. Okay, your cap ni kalau boleh lagi nampak cantik lagi baik polyethyl ni boleh lah, polyethyl. Labelkan polyethyl. Poly ni banyak ni, 4 je Dinesh Okay, so nampakkan banyak sikit. So splice the intron, tinggalkan exon Right, so splicing. Tulis polyethyl kat sini poly means banyak. Okay, gambar kalau boleh cari yang lebih baik, lebih better Dinesh. Okay, next, after RNA processing, translation will occur to complete the synthesis of this kind of protein. So, translation is synthesis of polypeptide. Okay, you dah start with, describe, apa ni, define. Okay, translation ini 20 markah So, sorry, 16 markah Sebab tadi splicing ni 4 markah. Okay, so ini akan jadi 16 markah. So, 16 markah weh pecahan dia So 2 marks will be your diagram, 14 marks will be your explanation. Okay, translation ni point dia banyak sikit Right, so let's start with definition dulu. Translation is a synthesis of polypeptide using genetic information encoded in mRNA. Okay, translation yang ini okay Definition ni boleh terima, 1 markah kat sini. Okay, next you apa ni support dengan diagram. Okay, diagram ni dia letak ada tRNA, ada large and ada small, ada start pada ada start codon, ada stop codon the mRNA. Okay, and then the E side kalau boleh labelkan dia E pi Okay, the E side, P side and A side, right? Elongation, termination, release factor. Ini okey lah. Gambar macam tu rasa alright. Okay, now cuma nanti peptide bond dia tak nampak. Peptide bond. Okay, kalau boleh Dinesh cuba cari gambar untuk elongation. Elongation ni sebab ada 3 step Dinesh. Okay, because initiation and termination tak ada masalah. Tapi for elongation, teacher nak you try to find support Because elongation ni banyak point. cubical elongation kan ada 3 step right? 1, 2, 3 eh. Codon recognition, peptide bond formation. Okay, so kena ada apa tu? Peptide bond formation and translocation. Okay, so kena ada gambar. Dinesh, are you okay Dinesh?
Cikgu, kalau lebih daripada satu diagram, okay ke?
It's okay. As long, sebab kat sini, kalau yang ini okay lah eh. You dah tunjukkan keperluan. Yang ni cikgu suka. Yeah, you tunjukkan the requirement to start the translation. Tapi when it comes to process, this one okay. Tapi when it comes to elongation, elongation Dinesh not really nampakkan cover the 3 step. So that means diagram satu, satu lagi carikan step elongation, nanti you letak dekat sini, dekat elongation ni. Dinesh eh? Elongation nanti kamu letak eh, because elongation ni kamu kena tunjukkan eh, the apa ni, the amino acid TRA. Okay, amino acid TRA datang eh, carry the apa ni, carry the specific amino acid. Okay, ni anticodon dia, in sini codon dia. Right, because codon recognition ni penting eh, baru boleh elongate. Kalau tak, so initiation tadi baru start apa? Initiator tRNA. Okay, so next step kalau tak ada, tak berlaku codon recognition, elongation tak boleh berlaku. Teacher nak you take note that one eh. Okay, so try to find one diagram eh, to support that. Okay, so initiation start with small ribosomal start unit bind to mRNA. Okay, yes, good, satu markah. Initiator tRNA, ini nama khas dia eh. TNA yang khas untuk bawa carry the anticodon for AUK. Okay, AUK is apa? Start codon. Okay, AUK is start codon. So anticodonnya ialah UAC eh. Ingat tu. Okay, start codon kat sini anticodon. Okay, so this is anticodon. Okay, mRNA is start codon. Okay, AUK. Okay, so initiator dia carry methionine with anticodon UAC attached to start codon AUG, right? Okay, good. Okay, the union of mRNA, initiator tRNA and small ribosomal start unit followed by attachment of light ribosomal start unit. Okay, kita panggil dia sebagai translation initiation complex. This one, okay. Okay, di Indonesia, yang ini perfect. Right? Okay, elongation. Elongation ada 3 step. Okay, codon recognition, so and amino acid, okay. So as you all know, dekat large subunit ni ada 3 site kan, A, E, PA. Okay, so and amino acid TRNA molecule with anticodon complementary to the exposed mRNA codon bind at A site. Okay, so sekarang ni amino acid TRNA will bind to the A site. So mRNA codon and A site form hydrogen bond with anticodon of an incoming molecule of tRNA. So dia akan forming hydrogen bond sementara di kelas eh. Okay, untuk allow peptide bond formation. Right, so ini betul ni okay. Okay, peptide bond formation, the large ribosomal site unit catalyzed by the enzyme that the peptidyl transferase cause the formation of peptide bond between the polypeptide and the P site and with the newly amino acid in the A site. Yes, very good. Okay, ini okay. And Dinesh, and the steps separate the tRNA at the P site from going polypeptide chain and transfer the chain now on one amino acid longer to the okay, jap. The P site from going polypeptide chain and transfer the chain now one amino acid longer to the tRNA at the site. Apa maksud kat sini ni? Now one more amino acid longer to the tRNA at the A site. Nah, ni boleh lah, okay. Ini macam ayat buku juga ni kan. Okay, then translocation. Okay, ini eh, translocate ni dia move eh. Right, so it move to the E side, the tRNA. Okay, akan move to the E side, dia akan keluar, leave the ribosome. And the tRNA attach polypeptide from the A side akan move to the P side. Ha, tu translocation, pindah eh, pindah tempat. Right, and anticodon remain bonded to the mRNA codon. So next codon not available, the A side, yes. So the 3 step of elongation continue codon by codon until it polypeptide that chain is completed. Okay, so done. This one okay. Tak ada masalah. Okay, now macam nak stop. Okay, termination akan apa ni? Occur when one of the 3 eh. Okay, iaitu UUA, UGA atau UAC. These 3 stop codon. Okay, So dah sah jumpa je UA atau UGA, okay, dia akan hydrolyze the bond between the polypeptide and its RNA in the P site. So ini akan menunjukkan proses dah nak tamat eh. So this pre-polypeptide and translation complex disassemble, right? And apa lagi? Finally, the polypeptide refer to the protein which characterize S. Okay. So that's all untuk apa ni sharing eh for question 3. Okay Dinesh eh, nanti teacher share dengan you this correction. Right, now proceed to with Vihang. Okay, Vihang dah buat siap-siap dalam PowerPoint for question 4. Okay, question 4 consider C4 kelas eh. Okay, consider as a C4. That means the highest level where you need, you must be able to explain. Wait eh. This great. Okay, 4A. Right, 4A, Vihang punya. Okay, so this is Vihang punya question 4. Sorry. Semua okey, senyap gitu. Tidur apa?
Okey.
Okey je.
Okey, so Vihang start dengan when mutation occur in DNA, segment of E. coli and causes changes LXE. Okey, ini soalan lah eh. Okey, like, what is LXE? LXE no longer responsible. Okey, kat sini Vihang tak berapa tepat ni eh. LXE no longer responsible. That means LXE sekarang undergo mutation. Okay, bila mutation, the gene is still there. The gene of LXE, okay, LXE eh, ada lagi. Cuma dah berlaku changes. Ha, itu konsep mutation eh. Okay, LXE mutated eh, like what you mentioned here eh. Bila mutated, bukan maksudnya tak responsible to produce. Maksudnya enzyme produce. Tetapi enzyme tu macam mana? Okay, so betulkan sikit kat sini Vihang ya, your point here. Okay Vihang. Okay next, mechanism on apron. Okay, when lactose is present, allolactose which is isosomal lactose is formed. Okay, one mark. Okay, allolactose bind to allosteric site of irreplaceable protein which produced by regulatory gene and causing conformational shape. Yes, good Vihang. The irreplaceable protein cannot longer bind to the operator. Yes. The RNA polymerase can bind to the promoter. Okay. Okay, dapat satu markah kat sini. Okay, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 markah dah. RNA polymerase will transcript the lag gene. However, only lag Y and lag A gene will be transcript. Okay. RNA polymerase akan transcript. Ni point 4 ni hati-hati Vihang. Ya. Sini kamu dah, kat sini dah silap konsep sikit. Lag Z gene cannot be transcript. Tak tepat. Lag Z gene tetap akan be transcripted. Cuma the apa ni? The genetic code, okay? The genetic code or the genetic information that produce will be changed. Okay? So dia tak boleh kata cannot be transcript eh? Salah tu eh? Okay? Dia transcript semua. Okay? RNA polymerase akan transcript the mutated gene. Okay, RNA dia tak tahu eh gene tu change, bertukar ke tak eh. Kerja dia hanyalah untuk transkrip dia dia apa ni, the genetic code. Eh, dia tak tahu pun, jadi dia tak ada kuasa pun untuk tak boleh transkrip. Boleh faham kelas eh? So point 4 ni tolong betulkan Vihang eh. Kat sini memang kat sini Vihang dah C4 kat sini kurang tepat lah Vihang apply. Kat sini lah C4 nya kelas ni, you must apply your understanding of mutated eh kat sini. Right, so C4 kena betulkan and point 4 kena betulkan eh. RNA polymerase will transcribe the mutated lag gene Z. Okay, lag Y and lag A gene. Tiga-tiga dia transkrip sebab dia tak ada kuasa untuk pilih. Oh ini sebab mutation kena, tak boleh transkrip tak eh. Okay, so lag Z cannot be transcript, tak boleh ni, memang tak boleh eh Vihang eh. Right, so boleh Vihang? Okay, so dia bukannya okay, lost information. Information dia ada, tapi informationnya berlaku apa Vihang? Bertukar, yeah? Changes, bukan yeah, loss eh. Yeah. Dia bukan loss, the information become change. Okay, Kita kan cikgu dah kuliahkan, instead of A, dia jadi G mungkin. So, jadi bila dia akan translate, dia akan translate wrongly lah eh. Dia akan translate G ni, bukannya A tu. Okay? Hmm. So and then translation occur only enzyme, okay. Translation occur and only enzyme premiase, ni. So, point 5 pun Vihan kena betulkan lah eh. Alright? Enzyme beta colloids produce. Okay, is produced, but kat sini kena sebut eh, right? Enzyme produce, but enzyme beta-oxidase produce, kalau nak cakap ialah mutated ataupun dia panggil degradation. Okay, satu lagi teacher nak kamu ni eh, kelas. mRNA yang ada tiga gen ini, cari nama dia. Poly apa? Poly mRNA. Ini satu lagi unik point eh. Sebab dalam eukaryot tak ada eh. Yang kita belajar dalam question 3, dia akan hasilkan satu je mRNA. Okay, yang ada prime cap dengan polyethyl. Tapi untuk leg apron, dia ada tiga gen sekali mRNA bawa. Okay, sekali tiga gene eh. So, nama gene, apa nama mRNA tu? Cuba bagi clue, poly. So, poly what? Cari eh, itu poin yang penting. So, poin 5 ni, okay, bukan tak hasil eh. Enzyme beta-glucosidase not be produced ni tak tepat eh, Bina. Kena betulkan. Okay, kena betulkan di sini eh. So, when there is no enzyme, so bukan tak ada enzyme. Enzyme beta-glucosidase jadi degradation. So, bila degradation, okay, the enzyme cannot atau fail to hydrolyze or break down the lactose into glucose and galactose. Okay, satu lagi point yang Vihang lupa sini, nyatakan function permease eh. Okay, nyatakan function permease and juga transacetylase. Right, di sini eh. Permease ni apa function dari Vihang? Apa satu markah? Transacetylase ni apa function dia? Another one, ada yang mark eh. So when there is no enzyme responsible to hydrolyze lactose, glucose, lactose is undigestible. Okay. So So the individual have, jadi summary Vihang kena sebut eh, person okay, atau individu yang show this this type of mutation that yang tak boleh hydrolyze lactose, we call them as lactose intolerance. Okay, so ini antara point yang Vihang kena betulkan lah Vihang eh. Especially point 4 and point 5 eh. Almost 4 o'clock class. So our part B. Okay, part B, problem lactose intolerance, very good. Okay, Vihang this one okay, good eh. So apa yang kena suggest kat baby ni, okay, kena ambil apa tu, susu eh. So Vihang tu pilih Similac. Okay, Similac, alright, susu Similac, satu markah produk dia. Okay, and then kena letak dia punya nutritional fact. Ini Vihang ambil daripada Similac ni Vihang eh. Vihang?
Ya. Yeah.
Vihang ambil nutritional fact ni daripada Similac.
Ya, betul.
Ke ni you nak ambil somewhere else?
No. Ini sama brand dengan itu.
Similac eh? This from Similac?
Ya, betul. Similac total
okay. Similac, right. Kalau Similac, okay. And then, after that, dia minta kamu nyatakan apa benefit eh? Okay, so make sure ada tak lactose free? Jumpa tak lactose free? Kat sini lower lah eh? Lower. So kalau better lah, ni lactose free lah. Ini cikgu kan cari kalau tak ada, tak dapat markah eh? Lactose free.
98% lah. Sama lah.
Ni kan lactose free ni okey lah. Alright. So last but ni benefit dia pertama. Okay. Cikgu akan cari energy eh Vihang. Nak supply energy to the baby. Tak ada ni. Okay. The baby will digest the milk better. The amount of lactose is very small. Reduce tummy sensitivity. Okay. Tummy sensitivity ni cuba mention lebih tepat lah apa dia. Okay, tummy sensitivity ni contohnya bloating stomach. Sebut eh, tummy sensitivity ni contohnya bloating stomach eh. Sebutkan specific eh, dose yang akan buat eh. And then energy, kena sebut energy tu the first one. Okay, apa lagi untuk baby? Kalsium, of course, right? Okay, ada tak kalsium sini? Kalsium, kena sebut eh. Kalsium untuk apa untuk baby?
Kalsium? Bone and teeth.
Yes, kalsium untuk growth eh. Growth for bone. Okay, growth and bone growth. Okay, kat sini kena betulkan sikit bang eh. Alright, so I think that's all eh. For our apa ni discussion petang ni. Nanti teacher share yang tu eh, Vihan. Dengan kamu. Okay. Okay. Alright, so back to our class. Nak tengok balik. Cikgu seorang je dekat dalam kelas ni. Mana orang lain ni? Okay, so cikgu nak you turn, okay, attendance kita dah sign in. Teacher dah discuss 3 soalan. Okay, petang ni. Alright, so can you please turn in your camera before we stop our class? Jom, class. It's ready 4 o'clock. Teacher nak you ready for your... Dinesh. Macam hero Hindustan, Dinesh. Sejak you duduk rumah. You tak balik. Tak balik ke, Dinesh?
Saya balik, cikgu.
Tak balik lagi, cikgu.
Siapa yang ada... Oh, Syauki yang tak balik Terengganu itu.
Ya, cikgu.
Oh, Syauki ada lah kat B. Mana Syauki?
Kita bilik je tu. B2.
Oh, B2. Ramai?
Tak pun. Sikit lah.
Okey lah eh. So, bertabarlah Syauki. Nanti tunggu Farhana bawa balik kopok lekor banyak-banyak tau. Cover balik untuk Syauki. Okey, Farid, orang Bahau, okey?
Okey, teacher.
Alright. So mana lagi? Jiha, mana Afrina, mana Kainat? Kainat, mana Menyorok? Dan Ashika?
Dinesh.
Rindu ke Farid? Farid rindu Dinesh rupanya. Okeylah kelas eh. So our class today we end until here. So tomorrow we start 10 o'clock class. Okay eh? Okay, so all the best for your UPS kejap lagi. Okay, careful eh. Jawab soalan senang je. Cikgu garanti soalan senang, cuma jangan careless mistake. Okay, 17 question. Baca betul-betul eh. W besar, W kecil tu baca betul-betul. Jangan simply you pilih je tanpa faham. Okay, alright class eh. So that's okay, all go. For our class today. Thank you very much. Tomorrow kita meet again eh. Alright.